वेलकम एंड गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल बीएससी फर्स्ट ईयर स्टूडेंट ऑफ फिशरी साइंस इन ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ सेमिस्टर सेकंड पेपर थर्ड फ्रेश वाटर एक्वाकल्चर टेक्नोलॉजी. इन दिस पेपर थर्ड इन फर्स्ट टू पार्ट we have detailed discuss. In first part we have seen the introduction of aquaculture and definitions of aquaculture. What is in by aquaculture? What is this aquaculture? These are to be greatly influenced, greatly affected. How this aquaculture, these are to be important to world's point of view as well as for the fisherman's point of view. This aquaculture, these are to be important, it is to be most useful. And in second lecture we have seen that importance of aquaculture, number of importance which is to we have seen. Due to these number of importance, this aquaculture, these are to be more important, it is to be most benefited. Due to these aquaculture, common fisherman, a low fisherman or a simple fisherman, it can increase its living standard. Ultimately, it can develop community development. Community is to be developed. His society is to be developed. Society is to be developed. Village is to be developed. Village is to be developed. Taluka is to be developed. Then taluka is to be developed. That is, district is to be developed. And ultimately, it is to be developed, uplift the state as well as the nation, national condition. That's why this aquaculture, these are to be important. These are to be most useful, which is to we have already seen in last part. Now in today's part, this aquaculture, these are to be important. What is the aim? What is the objective of this aquaculture? Why this aquaculture, these are to be studied? What is the use of aquaculture? Why this aquaculture, these are to be important? What is the purpose of to study the aquaculture? Or what is the aim of this aquaculture to study, to understand? The objective of aquaculture, these are to be various types of objectives for aquaculture. These objectives, these are to be important. We have seen one by one in this lecture, in this part. That is object, importance, objective and scope of aquaculture. In this, objectives of aquaculture. Objectives of aquaculture. Objective of aquaculture is achieve. Objective of aquaculture is achieve higher fish production from available or minimum water resources. Aquaculture produce, aquaculture farms or achieve higher fish production from available or minimum water resource by diversification in technology, species to be cultured in sustainable and eco-friendly way, and it includes following aspects. Why these objectives of aquaculture, these are to be important? Why these objectives of aquaculture, these are to be important? It is to be more useful because objective of aquaculture is achieve higher fish production from available or minimum water resources, either from available resources or either from the minimum water resources by diversification in technology, species to be cultured in sustainable and eco-friendly way. Those fishes, these are to be cultured. Those fishes, these are to be grown. These are to be cultured in sustainable and eco-friendly way, eco-friendly manner, sustainable manner. And it includes following aspects. What is the objective? The first objective, the type of organisms to be cultured. For example, fish, prawns, oyster, mussel, seaweed, etc. Means due to the aquaculture, the organisms, animals, it can be cultured, fish can be cultured, prawn can be cultured, oyster can be cultured, or that is a seaweed can be cultured. Means to culture these aquatic animals, culture of these fishes, prawns, mytilus, oyster, this aquaculture, these are to be important, it is to be most useful. The type of culture techniques such as pond culture, fishes, these are to be cultured in pond. Raceway culture, a special type of ponds which is to be constructed, created inside the reservoirs or the rivers or lakes. It is called as the raceway culture, cage culture, pen culture, raft culture, etc. Means type of culture techniques such as pond culture, raceway culture, cage culture, culture, pen culture, then soft culture or the raft culture. Means depending upon this culture technique, we can perform which type of aquaculture these are to be done. The aquatic environment in which the culture is to be carried out, such as freshwater, brackwater and marine water or sea water. The aquatic environment in which the culture is to be carried out. The aquatic environment in which culture is to be carried out, such as freshwater, aquatic environment, such as brackish water environment, or such as seawater environment, in which culture technique, such as these ponds, raceway, or these page culture, cane culture, raft culture, it is to be done, but it is to be the aquatic environment in which culture carried out, such freshwater culture, brackish water culture, or seawater culture. A specific factor of the environment used for culture, such as cold water or warm water aquaculture. Not only it is to be done by fresh water, marine water, or it is to be by a brackish water, but a specific sector of the environment used for culture, such as cold water culture or such as warm water culture. Cold water culture, fishes these are to be cultured in cold water, or fishes these are to be cultured in warm water, it is called as culture of fishes in the environment such as cold water or stand water. Following are the various aquaculture objectives. Remember that here is a missing. Yes, what is the missing? That is the following. Following are the objectives of aquaculture. Which are the following objectives, and with this objective aquaculture these are to be performed. Number one, to obtain maximum yield of aquatic animals. These are to be important. Means with the help of this aquaculture we can produce, with the help of these aquaculture technique, with the help of these methods, we can produce maximum yield of the aquatic animal, or aquatic food animal can be cultured with aquaculture. Our second objective, to obtain palatable and richly nutritive fish flesh. Due to this aquaculture of fishes, to obtain palatable chavich karela bunto ruchist aslela ruchi aslela to obtain palatable and richly nutritive fish flesh, those are the maximum minerals, maximum requirement which is to be available, maximum for the human body. That requirement these are to be fulfilled when we have consumed the fish. It is called as richly nutritive fish is to be a palatable and richly nutritive fish. Such fish these are to produce with the help of aquaculture. With the help of aquaculture, byproduct for fishing industry. Number of byproducts these are to be formed with the help of this aquaculture, and this aquaculture these are to produce the such number of byproducts with culture system, which culture method. Means this aquaculture these are to produce, these are to be formed the byproduct for fishing industries, and form the byproduct. To study local and geographical distribution. What is the objective of aquaculture? To study local and geographical distribution. Which are the local animals? Which are the local fishes? Which fishes are the geographical? How these are to be distributed? How these are to be migrated from fresh water to marine water, or marine water to fresh water? Means to study local and geographical distribution and abundance of organisms, with the help of aquaculture it is to be done, it is to be performed. To study temporal changes in the occurrence. This aquaculture is to be most useful. To study the local and geographical distribution and abundance of organism with the help of this aquaculture. Those are the changes which is to be occurring in local fish. Those are the changes in geographical, and those are the abundance in these fishes as well as these animals in local and different condition. To understand, to study these changes to these local geographical distribution, it is to be done by the studying the aquaculture. To study temporal changes in the occurrence, abundance and activities of organism, not only geographical distribution and abundance, but when we have studied the temporal changes in occurrence, temporary changes, these are to be occur due to abundance, temporary changes, these are to be occur due to activities in these animals, fish animal, means occurrence, abundance and objectives of organisms. These are objectives, these abundance and occurrence, these are to be studied due to the temporal changes. How these temporal, not permanent, temporal changes, these are to be studied, temporal changes, these are to be understood. Or to study interrelationship, to study the interrelations between organisms in populations and community. Again, this aquaculture, these are to be important, these are to be most useful. Why this aquaculture, these are to be most important, useful? To study interrelations between organisms in populations and communities. Those organisms, these are to present, these organisms, the populations and communities, the which are the interrelation, these are to be occur. This interrelation, these are to be study with the help of these aquaculture. That's why this objective is another important. To study the evolutionary development of all these interrelations, this aquaculture, it is also important. This aquaculture is also most useful. Why it is to be important? To study the evolutionary development, all these interrelations, these are to be understand, these are to be studied, means with the help of this aquaculture, which are the evolution which is to be takes place, and which are the evolutionary changes, these are to be occur in animal, it can be studied with aquaculture. To study conservation and management of natural resources, those are the natural resources that may be river, tributaries, reservoirs. These natural resources are oceans, seas and brackish water. These are the natural resources. To study the conservation and management of natural resources, this aquaculture, these are to be important, these are to be useful, means with the help of this conservation and management of natural resources, we can perform the aquaculture. To study the biological productivity, this may be best for mankind. Just I have told you earlier period, what is the important aspect? That is biological productivity. To control the biological diseases, to control the malaria, to control the hathipai, to control the other different diseases, these fishes, these are to be important, these are to be most useful, means to study the biological productivity and changes which is to be occur in fish, and this biological productivity, which changes these are to be occur, which fluctuation these are to be seen, all these are to be studied when we have studied the biological productivity of these aquaculture, how it is to be best served for human beings, for mankind. It is to be, you have seen, it is to be, you have. To boost economy of the nation by way of increasing per capita production, to generate the employment opportunities for the unemployed persons, to generate the employment opportunities for the unemployed persons, then to boost the economy of the nation by way of increasing per capita production, the structural adaptation and functional adjustment of organisms to their physical environment, to utilize fully the national water resources available to its maximum, those natural resources, these are to be available as possible, as these natural resources use maximum to fully utilize and produce the these aquaculture resources, to uplift the socio-economic status of the people, to uplift the socio-economic status of the people of the Indian subcontinent, this aquaculture, these are to be important, these are to be most useful. To earn the foreign exchange revenue by transport of fish to foreign countries, this aquaculture, these are to be important. To earn foreign exchange revenue by transport of fish to foreign countries, this aquaculture, these are to be important. To culture ornamental fishes for beautifying aquariums, this aquaculture, these are to be important, these are to be useful. To culture larvicidal fishes for control of mosquito larvae, this aquaculture, these are to be important. to increase production of food in the form of fish, to increase the production of food in the form of flesh, to increase the production of fish in the form of, that is the fish and non-fish organism, and to increase the production of food and decreasing the pressure on the other food atom, this aquaculture, these are to be important, these are to be most used. Means structural adaptations to boost the economy of nations, increasing per capita in production, to generate unemployment opportunities for the employed person, to utilize fully the natural water resources available in maximum way, maximum manner, to uplift the socio-economic status of the people of India subcontinent, to earn foreign exchange revenue by transport of fish to foreign countries. Those fishes, these are to be transported to foreign countries, maximum foreign currency, these are to be earned, and increase the nation's earning. To culture ornamental fishes, it is also important. To culture larvicidal fishes for control of mosquito, it is also important. To increase production of food in the form of fish and decreasing the pressure on the food, it is also essential, it is also done by aquaculture. And that's why this aquaculture, these are to be important, these are to be most useful. All these above, all these are the various objectives, and with these objectives we have fulfilled, with this objective we have assessed the study of aquaculture in detail. Hope all these objectives, these are to be more or less essential, all these objectives, these are to be studied maximum in maximum level, and these objectives, these are to be fulfilled when we have studied the fish and aquaculture. And with this, the first article, that is introduction, then importance, scope of aquaculture, that is objective of aquaculture, these are to be done. The last part of this article, that is the scope of aquaculture, we have seen, we have studied in next part. Any problem, any difficulty, please ask. Thank you, all of you.